Hey Jarvis, how do I get into software engineering?
Well, dramatized, slightly younger version of me, do you mind if I make a video so that other people like us could get some value out of it? Hi everyone, today we're gonna talk about what I do for a living, which is software engineering. Software development?
Programming?
Coding?
Baking a software lasagna?
Anyway, I live in San Francisco and get paid to build software systems that power a popular website on the internet. I get to work at a company that I love and I'm super excited to see my coworkers every morning. Living the dream. But how did you get started? Before we get to that, I want you to know that you, yes you, the person watching this video on your computer, you can be a software engineer, developer, programming, Cody person if you want to. I feel like a lot of the doubt around this is rooted in a lack of representation of people who look like you or people who have similar backgrounds to you. And these very pervasive but very specific stereotypes about software engineers? Oh, come on! I'm making this video because my own path to this career was really serendipitous. I learned about computer science from a podcast, and I didn't have any programming classes at my high school, so I tried to do self-study. Ooh, that was real bad. There's a lot of paths that result in software jobs, none more valid than the next. There's really no silver bullet to becoming a software engineer. You can go to a four-year university, you can self-study, you can do a 10-week boot camp. These paths all have their own advantages and disadvantages, but in my career, I've worked with people from each of these backgrounds, and everything has been peachy keen. I personally went to a four-year university and studied computer science. It was great for me because I was 18 in this really exploratory period in my life and I didn't think I could learn all this stuff on my own. Also, and I just want to clear this up, at no point was I good at math. You do not need to be a math genius to be a software engineer. Should I learn Python or Java, iOS or Android, React or Angular? My advice is to learn whatever piques your interest. I wrote my first program on a TI-84 calculator because that's all I had at the time. And now I do back-end web development in Python. I've also done Android stuff in Java and front-end in JavaScript. I even had a class in college where we made Game Boy Advance games in C. Trying to optimize your learning for what's hot right now is not a sound strategy because this stuff is always changing. And more important than not, learning something that's interesting to you is gonna give you a much higher chance of success. This stuff is hard and it's surprisingly difficult to motivate yourself when you don't like what you're doing. Also, if you try a bunch of things and decide software isn't for you, that's a valuable experience because now you know a path not to go down. And that's life. But do I do Udacity or Coursera? Can I take online classes? What books should I read? Use whatever resources most attractive to you. Do you prefer structured courses or books or YouTube videos? Learn whatever feels fun. If you're doing this in college and don't have control over your learning resources, that's okay. Join an on-campus community and help bring each other up. That's honestly what got me through. Think of a project, something small that you want to exist, and see how far you get. Don't have any ideas? Well, follow a tutorial. Like I said, this stuff is hard. It was hard for me, but you will make progress, and for me, that was really gratifying. Also, don't feel like you need to have 100% understanding of what's happening when you're learning whatever you're learning. There's literally infinite complexity under the hood. Follow your curiosity and keep moving forward. Even 50% comprehension is better than 0%. And if you get stuck, that's okay. Everyone gets stuck. Google your errors. Get familiar with Stack Overflow. If you don't see the answers to your questions online, make an account and start asking the questions. You can do this. That's all I got for today, but if this video inspired just one person to get started, that's amazing and I've done my job. If this video helped you, please like it or share it with someone or subscribe, and let me know in the comments if you want to see more content like this. I'm still trying to figure out what this channel even is. Anyway, I'll see you next time.